we speak with our African friends, trying to explain to them that neutrality is not the answer.
Far from the front lines of the Ukraine-Russia war, both countries have been fighting a proxy battle to charm the African continent and earn support for their relative sides. Eritrea and Mali have sided with Russia, whereas about half of African states have consistently voted on Ukraine's side. But in a February 2023 UN resolution calling for Russia to withdraw, of the 32 states to abstain, almost half of them were African. A further six didn't show up to the vote at all. The war has put many African countries in an awkward position, caught between Western-backed Ukraine and Russia, with whom many countries have historic ties.
La volonté des uns et des autres menace de transformer l'Afrique en terrain de bataille géostratégique, recréant de ce fait une nouvelle version de la guerre froide.
Many African nations have indeed refused to openly take sides.
Nous avons pris une position abstentionniste, une position de neutralité, une position de non-alignement pour éviter que ce conflit puisse atteindre d'autres régions, notamment le continent africain.
But both Russia and Ukraine have been ramping up their efforts to woo African countries, with Putin and Zelensky's foreign ministers, Lavrov and Kuleba, being deployed on multiple wartime trips to the continent.
You and us are on the same page.
There are two things of huge importance in this charm offensive: the supply of grains and the flow of weapons. Ukraine and Russia are among the world's largest producers of both grains and fertilizers, crucial to the harvests of many countries on the continent. The problem for Ukraine has been delivering its grain to Africa, with Russia controlling the Black Sea and hindering grain export from Ukrainian ports.
Russia attacked Ukraine. Nevertheless, we continue to do everything that we can to ensure Ukrainian grain reaches Africa.
For now, a shaky deal has allowed grain to continue being exported. But Ukraine wants to persuade African countries not to switch to Russian grain, and to demand Russia stops obstructing the so-called grain corridor. But it remains a key bargaining chip for Russia.
Руководствуясь потребностями в первую очередь африканских стран, Россия недавно согласилась на пролонгирование еще на 60 дней заключенной в Стамбуле договоренности по вывозу через Черное море украинского продовольствия и разблокированию российского сельхозэкспорта и поставок удобрений. При этом мы настаиваем именно на пакетном характере данной сделки, прежде всего в интересах африканских.
The question of weapons is a murkier issue. South Africa was recently accused of selling arms to Russia, which it subsequently denied. Even more telling, leaked US Pentagon documents obtained by the Washington Post suggested that Egypt had agreed to secretly sell 40,000 rockets to Russia, before appearing to backtrack and supply ammunition to Ukraine instead. Again, Egypt has denied this. But not only does Ukraine want African countries to cease selling weapons to Russia, it's also seeking arms for itself. Zelensky's chief of staff, Andrei Yermak, admitted, "We need to establish diplomatic relations very quickly, because in some of these countries, we are looking for the weapons we need." But when it comes to diplomatic relations with Africa, the two nations have not started on equal footing. Russia, and previously the Soviet Union, can draw on much longer historical links with many African countries, especially those in which it directly provided military support during the decolonization era. And in countries like Mali and Central African Republic, ongoing military assistance through the Russia-backed Wagner Group mercenaries only deepens ties between the nations.
Nous vous accueillons les bras ouverts. La Russie est ici à la demande du Mali et la Russie répond de façon efficace aux besoins du Mali en termes de renforcement des capacités de nos forces de défense et de sécurité.
Ukraine, in contrast, has only 10 embassies across the continent, less than a quarter of Russia's presence. Ukraine is fundamentally trying to rally countries around the world to support its 10-point peace plan, calling for the withdrawal of Russian troops. But African nations are not remaining passive. Among recent efforts to mediate the war is a planned meeting by six African countries to end the stalemate.
Africa does need to put forward an initiative, a peace initiative that could help to contribute to the solution of that conflict. The two leaders that I had occasion to speak to, that is President Putin and President Zelensky, agreed that they would be willing to receive the mission of the African heads of states in both Moscow and Kyiv.
So although far from speaking with one voice, Africa's diplomatic weight could continue to shape the competition for support between Ukraine and Russia.